Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Ken Chrysler, and my name is Nusan Marafia. And welcome to another great episode. We're going to start off with the Divas match. This is for the Divas title. Of course, Melissa brought friends. She can't not bring friends. But I've heard that Tiffany has brought some friends as well. So we'll see how that works out. I believe Bryson Clay's over there. He's the new guy. But anyway, what a disgrace by Daniel the Deep. Barack is doing his stretches, Newsom, and he just gets slack for it. According to Daniel the D, he could smell his skin from the hallway. So I don't get it. I just do not get it. And Bryson Clay behind them there. Not an official member of Melissa's Asylum. I don't know why. But Newsom, who you think's going to win tonight? Well, again, I do not know. It's about even on this match. It's going to be very hard to pick. They're very good. Both of them are. I like them both. I heard Tiffany brought a little crew with her as well. Yeah, she has brought, of course, I guess it's her boyfriend, Mentally Sinister, and Colossus. If you don't know by now, I'm sure we haven't said it on the channel yet, Colossus is one of Macau's favorite characters. Now, we haven't seen Macau, but Mentally Sinister also is almost like Macau, basically, besides the pot. But anyway, Colossus is a favorite of theirs, so he is like a bodyguard as of now. And it's great to see him. And Colossus has claimed that there will be no cheating tonight. So I cannot wait to see this. He heard my call for managers, and hopefully he cannot cheat as well. And we're going to see what happens there. I know Mentally's probably not. And Bryson Clay seems like, you know, someone that doesn't get involved, but if he does get involved, it's going to be bad news. So he seems like a fair guy as well, as mean as he is, I think, because he put Pennywise in a coma. Yeah, Pennywise isn't around anymore. But anyway, here we go. Tiffany versus Melissa. And Colossus is already doing a little patrol here. And look here. I don't know what he's doing. He's talking to a fan, I think. I don't know. But anyway, Tiffany's starting out good, it seems like. Colossus, I don't know what he's doing. I think he's talking to that guy. I don't know what. But anyway, Melissa and Tiffany, and now he's showing off for the three guys. I need to stop looking at him. He's causing distractions already, it seems like. And Tiffany so far in control of this match. Mark Wildhawk and Brian Bobo. Stop doing distractions. It's not funny. Goodness gracious. You know what, Newsom? I've had enough of these managers. I thought Colossus was going to come in here and do something good. And he's showing off. Look here. They don't care. You're blocking their view. Goodness gracious. Yeah, I don't know what he's thinking. He needs to pay attention to the match. Yeah, Macau likes this guy, apparently. I don't know why. It looks like someone that, you know what, we should kidnap him and recycle him and see how much money we get. That'd be a good idea, kid. We get a lot of money. Taking them to wherever they take them. Yeah, I don't know how all that works. I should have been more environmental friendly growing up. Yeah. I don't know exactly how that works, but look at Melissa, just so far dominating this match, and a good slam right there by her. She has been great on the channel. Tiffany, of course, has been a problem for Melissa as of late. Tiffany's got a lot of agility. She's a lot smaller. She can go around places faster, and that's a good advantage. Yeah, it is, Ken. I really enjoy it. And here comes Tiffany already. Doing good. And look at Vicious Swag. Here we started off, but Colossus isn't going to have it. He is not going to. And look, Colossus got in the. got in the ring. Goodness, Colossus, can you not grab the man? And look there. There is a fight breaking out outside of the ring between Colossus and Vicious Swag. Thank goodness. It's about time justice gets served on this channel. Yeah, it is indeed. And Colossus, oh man. Him and Vicious Swag are just, you know, uh-oh. Look there. Yeah, I need to be watching the match. And look at Melissa. Oh, man. Look at Colossus. Goodness gracious. Yeah, he's had enough. He has had enough. Oh, my. Oh, my. Look at Colossus. Oh, right on the pole. And look here. He doesn't care. Goodness gracious. He's about to get ejected. He's distracting the ref. And Melissa kicks out. And look at Colossus. Oh my goodness, and look at him. Oh man, he is just regulating Vicious Swag in this match. Look here. Yeah! He ain't going back in his corner. Look at the stare, and look at that little gesture he just gave him. I wonder what that meant. Yeah, I don't know. Probably something in Russia. Yeah. But anyway, Melissa, DDT. And look at Colossus, the stare down. It's beautiful. I love it. Yeah. And Melissa, Tiffany with a nice reversal. I feel like I'm watching two matches, but one's a staring contest. Yeah. Yeah, and like I said, let's talk about Daniel the D. Slapping Baraka. Baraka's just doing his stretches. Apparently he didn't put on deodorant or take a bath or something. And Daniel the D slapping. This guy's not a human. He's not accustomed to human culture, okay? He doesn't have to take a bath every day. How does Colossus take a bath? Just rinse, I don't know. I don't know. I feel like I'm going to mess up what kind of steel he is or what kind of metal, so I don't want to say nothing. Yeah, and still, oh man, he's just, Vicious Swag moved a little bit. Yeah, mentally he's going crazy. You're going a little too crazy. And so far, this match has been marvelous. And look at Vicious. Colossus just followed him. Everywhere he goes, Colossus goes. I love it. He is regulating these managers. Bryson Clay seems like he's not going to get involved. And look at him. He's got him in the corner. But look at Melissa. Melissa's back at it. And look, oh man, look at that leg drop there, and once again, but Vicious Swag's not going nowhere. Look at Melissa though, he might not need to. Look here, and a kick out by Tiffany. Wow. Colossus is the ultimate troll. I love it. Yeah, it's very enjoyable watching. Oh, look there, Vicious Swag touching Colossus. That might not be a good idea. Yeah, it might not be easy. I think he's a little sick of... Oh, man. I think he got a little sick of Colossus just staring him down. And look at Colossus putting him back near the barricade where he belongs. And look at Melissa. Melissa's dominating this match right now. So does it really matter at this point? She's taking the breather. I think she needs to go for the pin here. And now she's going for the pin. She could have just won that match, probably. And I don't know. She might still win it. And a kick out by Melissa. Wow. And Vicious Swag's just... He's afraid to move. Yeah, Ken. Yeah, he knows better. And Colossus is mentally cheering Tiffany on. Melissa's putting up a fight, though. It's going in her favor right now. And look there. Once again, the leg drops. Absolutely amazing. Oh, man. And Melissa with the... This is crazy. And look at Tiffany, that. Look here. Look at this. What a nice move there. And Tiffany. Oh, man. It's that one move again that she does. It's a very good move. And look... Oh, look at that reversal by Melissa. This is very interesting. I've never seen this way of the match. And look here. Tiffany Tyson with the power bomb. Wow. I cannot believe she has that strength. Well, she does, kid. And look here, yeah, it's about to be over. Yeah, if Tiffany locks this in, I think it's done. Look here. Oh my goodness. What a beautiful move by Tiffany. And it could be over here. Yeah, kid, it could be. And yes, it is. Tiffany Tyson wins. And Bryson Clay didn't get involved. You know, he was a fair man in this fight. I got to give him a little respect for that. Vicious Swag didn't get involved after that one. He did not get involved. He knew he was going to get whipped. But anyway, let me also remind you all tonight, I got some bad news. The interview isn't going to happen. Clifford Welch declared that the interview would bring hazard to the superstars. It's dangerous doing this interview. Well, Clifford Welch, how about, you know, I know I don't. You shouldn't take the demands of a psycho, but until you find him, we need to be a little comprehensive, I think. I don't know about you, but anyway, and look here. Mercury Morris, there's been a little beef going on backstage, I've heard, with DRS and the Hunters. Oh, that was a big mistake, Colonel. That was a big mistake. And here we go. A little backstage brawl. Here we go. Oh, man. Mercury, go. Look at him go. Look here. Oh, man. Throwing Colonel Sanders around. Oh, like a Raggedy Ann. And, oh, missed there. Yeah, the people backstage are running already. Yeah, they better run. This is a craziness. There's been a lot of backstage pranks. There's been a lot of backstage fights as of late. Between DRS and the Hunters. I know the bunny put rotten eggs in Mercury Morris's room. They're trolling the Hunters. And, you know, that's not a good idea. Because look here, look here! Colonel Sanders! Wow! What a nice reversal. Totally fooled me. Yeah, it was good. Yeah, it was. And, oh my goodness! Look at Colonel Sanders here with a DDT! Capitalizing! Oh my! Yeah, kid, if he wins this match, it'd be very big for him. It would. Oh my goodness. And Colonel Sanders putting up a fight. Uh-oh, he's got the briefcase. Missed that one. And look at, Mercury. Oh no, now Mercury's, oh man. That was a big mistake, Colonel. You better cook fried chicken instead of, thinking that, oh my goodness, these headshots are unreal. Yeah, they are, kid. Look there. Oh, man. A shot to the leg. Oh, man. A shot to the back. And, oh, man. Another shot. Goodness gracious. Oh, man. A kick to the face. This is unreal. Someone get the law up in here. And look here. Oh, my goodness. And look here. Here's a pedigree. Well, Colonel Sanders, oh, he's busted open. The glasses broke. They went in his face. The glass did. And look here. Oh, my goodness. More shots with that briefcase. To the ribs. Goodness gracious. I told you all. I keep on telling you all not to mess with these teams. The Hunters are unreal, and you got these doofuses trying to stop them. And look here. Yeah, nice try, Colonel. Oh, my goodness. Well, Mercury started it. Yeah, but Colonel should have ran. And look here. We're having a big man over-the-top match tonight. We're not going to do entrances. All these men, I believe, are over 7 foot. I believe some of them are even taller. And this is a six-man battle royale over-the-top. Yeah, it's going to be very good. Obviously, we wanted to do more, so we decided that we would not put the entrances in this match because a lot's going to occur tonight. And look here, oh man, we're already starting this six-man over 7 foot, I believe all these people are. There might be a 6'11 person or something. Might be. I'm not for sure. But they're all real tall. They're all pretty tall. They're all pretty big. It's a big man's match. And it's the Clifford Welch declared, we need these big men to go at it. Yeah. And, I like it. I like the style, and I know a lot of people might wish it was a Hell in a Cell, but it takes too long. Yeah, and it's too complicated getting out of the cell now because of insurance rights. That's part of the Obamacare that has been taking place on this camp. Yeah, premiums are high, so we gotta be careful with our superstars. Oh, I guess. I don't know. Well, I really do not know. I'm not going to get into that. And anyway, Harambe and Optimus. Oh, man. And look at the Big Daddy Slugger going after the Hawk. Look at these strikes by. Look at Harambe. Oh, man. The power there. A lot of people want to see Harambe move. And this is not a number one contenders match. But whoever wins, it's gonna give them a good resume. It's gonna add to their resume. So, Clifford's watching. He's watching this. Yeah, he is, Ken, and he was very impressed by putting all six of these men in. You know, Big Daddy and Sweet Tooth, both of them haven't been in any matches besides the video game Royal Rumble, which Clifford was very impressed. He was very impressed. And look here, Harambe is going to try the elimination on Optimus Prime. It's too early. It is way too early. And a lot of people are wondering about Stay Puft's performance. And the by the way, the main event will be tonight. The Brodkis and versus Blueneck with the Freak as the manager. That's going to be interesting. Blueneck said he has returned and he is ready to have his title returned to him. Which, no, it doesn't work that way. You gotta earn it. You lost it fair and square. And he wants it back. And he's getting, I mean, we still don't know. It's 1 week away. 1 week away. And all I've gotten is there's gonna be a world title match. That's all I've gotten. I don't know who's going to be in the match. I don't know why they're not telling me these things. But I know Blueneck's going to be in there. And the rumors are he could be a six-man ladder. So that's going to be very interesting. I don't know who's going to be in that match, though. Rumors are Blueneck's going to... Well, Blueneck's confirmed to be in it. Maybe the Freak, though. Maybe the Freak. They have not decided. We're a week away. Decide now. You know, I know it was complicated the first couple weeks. What in the world was that? Technical issues. I know it was complicated the first couple. Come on! You better not mess up on us. This is the big man's match. That's a no-no there. Anyway, where was I? Where was I? I know that there has been a lot of issues with Vortox dying, of course. And there it goes again. And Sweet Tooth, you can't tap out because, and we're sorry about that. Didn't even see that. You know, we've had a lot of issues with the Elgato as of late. And a new cord is on the way. One of the cords doesn't work. So that's why there hasn't been a lot of videos. I know it's a lot of excuses, but it was a miracle we got to put this week's episode together. Of course, Subscriber Night's coming around the corner, and Hawk has been eliminated. Wow. I did not expect for him to get eliminated first. Yeah, Ken, he's very tough, and looks like he doesn't have what it takes. Yeah, very shocking elimination there. Harambe's trying to eliminate Stay Puft. Optimus Prime is trying to go for this big... Oh, didn't work. On Sweet Tooth there. And, wow. This has been a crazy match tonight indeed. and all these men have been fierce competitors. And Sweet Tooth's been eliminated. Wow. Another one bites the dust. Yakin. And there's going to be surprises at the end. Apparently, I just got word from Clifford Welch. Something again happened backstage. They're going to show that at the end of the broadcast. Oh, my goodness. It's not major, whatever it is, because apparently it's not. It can't be major because we would have been told about it and told to evacuate. So it's not Cynthia Sale. Just something happened backstage. There was a fight again. Goodness gracious. What is up with the fights on these channels? This channel, I'm sorry. I'm acting like there's multiple ones now. I don't know, Kim, but Optimus just got eliminated. Wow. Wow. And we're down to the final three. A lot of people want to see Harambe get it. Yeah, a lot of people do. Stay Puft's very good, though. Yeah, but I wouldn't underestimate Big Daddy. I wouldn't underestimate him either. Look at Harambe. Wow. Look here. Oh, nice reversal by Big Daddy. And look here. Harambe with a reversal there. And Stay Puft now. There's a little double team there. And look here, kid. Oh, come on. Are you kidding me? The fans wanted it. Oh, my. Well, it's not going to happen today. But look here. Look at this. Look at Big Daddy. Oh, wow. And a lot of people do not like Stay Puft. He, he's part of Daniel the D's team. And, I mean, he's the toughest competitor out of all of them. You just saw Colonel Sanders go down. I just got word he's injured. Well, I don't know if he's injured or not. He was bleeding pretty bad, though. But he had to go to the hospital. I did get word on that. And Stay Puft, look here. Stay Puft. Oh. But not enough to eliminate Big Daddy quite yet. And I don't know. Big Daddy's hanging on. He could win this. You never know. Yeah, Ken. And I would like to see Big Daddy win this match. Stay Puft's good, though. I don't know who's going to win. I don't either. And look at Stay Puft Marshmallow. Look at this. This does not look good at all. And once again, he shows his sign of dominance. Oh, my goodness. And the Hunters need to take care of this guy. Not Colonel Sanders. Oh, my goodness. This is the guy you gotta go after. He is the strongest of the pack. And Crossbones is the second strongest. So, I don't know what's going on here. But anyway, and ladies and gentlemen, it is time for our main event as Brodkis, who has announced that he is back in the game with the Freak. Him and the Freak look good against D's or Us, but they cannot get in the tag team bracket just yet because Daniel the D filed a restraining order because he said they injured him. Well, apparently he could slap Brodkis still, so I think he's faking his whiplash. You know how he is, Daniel the Doofus. But anyway, Brodkis is back. He seems like he's got his moral compass despite his past. But here comes the Blueneck, and the Blueneck's not happy. He's already said it multiple times. Anyone that steps in that ring, first of all, he complained to Clifford Welch. He says, I'm a 9 or 10 time champion. We always lose count. And you're going to put me in a match possibly with 6 men in a ladder. You have got to be kidding me. And look at Blueneck. Oh my goodness. Wow. Oh man. And look at, he's having a little talk with the Freak. Yelled something at him. And oh my goodness, this does not look good. And Freak's an ethical man, so he's not going to get involved. Thank goodness. And look here, the Blueneck is in action tonight. Oh man, just so far dominating this fight. Goodness gracious, a lot of people have picked him as a favorite. to win the six-man ladder match. If it's going to, I guess it's going to be a six-man ladder match. That's what I've been told. I don't know nothing besides that. And I know that it's possibly going to be Blueneck's guaranteed because he has, and look at him showing off. And you know what? They don't like you. They do not like you. Look at Brodkis. He's going to make him pay. And look here. Oh, this is good. This is good. Look here. Wow. Brodkis, but it's way too early. Oh, wow. A nice attempt by Brodkis. Yeah, again, he's got to find a weakness. No one has ever found a weakness on the Brodkis as of yet. Yeah, and Blueneck's really good. He's really good. And the Freak could be in the six-man ladder. Clifford Welch hasn't decided yet who's going to be in the ladder match. And as for all the subscribers that want to suggest, oh, look here. This is uncalled for. He's going after the Freak. Call the law. The Freak never did nothing. And look here. And yeah, you might want to pay attention, Blueneck. Goodness gracious. And Brodkis is at it now. And it's great to see the brothers back. They're the best brothers ever. Ever to fight in the history of our channel. Or our league, whatever we have going on. But yeah, they're really great. The Smith brothers also as well are really good. They're retired though, so I don't expect them to come back anytime soon. And here comes the Blueneck. Look at this. The power. Wow. Brodkis weighs a lot. Yeah, he does good. And look there. There's the kick. Goodness gracious. This is the Brodkis can't even win this match. And then a kick out by Brodkis. Oh my goodness. Yeah, again, and it's not looking good. Yeah, but one thing that concerns me, okay, there's going to be two matches. There's two matches planned at Fastlane. First match is the tag match between the Hunters and D's R Us. That's going to be very good. Crossbones and Stapa versus Kiki Kyle and Mercury Morris. And we got that match going on, but obviously the Hunters are going to come to play. But the second match is a six-man ladder match. No one has an idea besides the Blueneck who's going to be in that match. And Clifford Welch has already made it a legit match, so I know a lot of people might have suggestions or predictions, but it's already done. Who's going to be in the match? But I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen. I know the Blueneck is very dominant, and he's also a cheater. Look here. Look at this disgusting act. He knows Brodkis can kick out easily because he's very strong. Oh man! Huh. He threw Brodkis just straight up in the air. And yeah, a lot of people are taking Blueneck as their favorite. He wins another title. Give me a break. I mean, oh, look at Brodkis. What a nice reversal there. If he wins another title, I am going to cry my eyes out. I am tired of him winning. The subscribers are tired of him winning. Yeah, beat the chest. Yeah. And Brodkis with the chest beat. But yeah, don't show off just yet. Goodness gracious. And Blueneck's going in for his finisher here. And missed it! He missed! He missed! And look here! Brodkis! What is this? Oh, wow! And Brodkis missed. And now he did. Look here. Yes, it's this move! This move has cost so many superstars. And the ref, come on! And not even a two. And look here. Here comes the submission. Brodkis has been, and look here, this is pretty good here. Brodkis has been working really good on the submission, but look at the Blueneck strength. Oh my goodness. Huh, but it did do some damage. That one did do some damage at least. And the chest pound again. Yeah. Brodkis is in control now. Yakin, and you never know. He's won the world title before. And nodding. Oh, I think it was a one, but nothing more than that. And look at the Blueneck here. Look at the power. Oh my goodness. And wow, look at that. It is not looking good for Brodkis. Just when you think you may be in control, the Blueneck once again proves why you're not. And look at the Blueneck here. Oh man. And I don't know what he's... Oh, look at Brodkis. What a nice reverse. What a roll out of the ring there. Yeah, kid. And look at the Blueneck here. Wow, look at the... And Brodkis, look at Brodkis here. Going for this move. Wow, what a powerful move. And Brodkis has a signature. And look here! Look here! Oh my goodness! Oh my! That hurts! That hurts! I don't care where you're from. That one hurts. Yeah, even it hurts enough. With someone really small. But yeah, he does. And Brodkis is taking control of this match, but look at the Blueneck with the reversal. The reversal here. And the kick. Oh my. And Brodkis is in big trouble. And a rope break. Wow. Brodkis putting up a fight against the former world champion. Oh man. Brodkis has won a couple world titles in his older days. It's been a long time, very long time since he's won a world. Not as bad as Daniel Vadim, but you know, it's been longer than Daniel Vadim's U.S. title. It's been like SmackDown versus Raw 2007, 2008. I think he was a reigning champ then. And look here, look at Brodkis working these submissions. And Blueneck's having quite a hard time getting out of this one, but looks like he's going to get out of it again. Look at that reversal. Wow, another rope kick. Goodness gracious. And look here, and look at the dirty move. Look at the dirty move that is called the law. You gotta be kidding me. Oh my. And Blueneck wins. How disgusting. You know, and look here, he's not done. Look, watch out, Freak! Watch out! He's coming right after you! Oh my! Brodkis is knocked out cold. Goodness gracious, is this called for? And look here. No, it is not, kid. It is not called for, I'll tell you that. This is a disgrace. And look at the Blueneck with the kick. Yeah. Kiki, I heard you've been hitting my superstars, you little ugly boy. You hear me, you little ugly boy? Ah! Yeah, and Daniel, this isn't a good idea. I'll give you bravery points. It's either bravery or stupidity at this point. Yeah, it's not bravery. Look here, look at him running like a little coward. That thought he could push Kiki. And Daniel, the door's locked. You can't get out that way. I don't know why they locked that door. It's a complete fire hazard. But yeah, Daniel, it wasn't a good idea. This is not a good idea at all. Yeah, I knew. Oh my goodness, what is he thinking? What is he thinking? Yeah, it wasn't a good idea, kid. No, it was not. And I'm going to enjoy this. This is going to be very good. This is unreal. And look at Daniel the D. Look at Kiki. Yeah, Kiki can show off. He's going to have a little bit of fun here. And I thought Daniel had an injury. He's pushing Kiki, isn't he? He's slapping Baraka, isn't he? Oh, my goodness. And Kiki... Oh, man. Look at that. And... Look at him running. You can run, but you can't hide, Daniel. Yeah, kid, he needs a good weapon. Yeah, and uh-oh. Look here, the TV. Oh, he's going to try to cheap shot Kiki. I'd like to see this one. Look here. Well, nice try, Daniel. Then a knockout punch. Oh, my goodness. And look at the trash can hit here. Daniel the D is a doofus. What are you thinking? This is might be the dumbest thing ever done in history. Yeah, kid, it's not a good idea. Yeah, Stay Puft not. Crossbones is off for the night. Colonel's in the hospital, and I don't know where Stay Puft is, but it's not around here. And then Daniel, once again, running from room to room, trying to get away. Uh-oh, he's got the briefcase here. Maybe a cheap shot here. Yeah. It's not going to work. And look here. Oh, my. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and call Daniel the doofus. Or the disaster, because that was a disaster for Daniel. No stars.